Hello everyone, welcome to another new video on my channel. Today I'm going to show you how I made these handmade papers without any blender or without any deckle or sieve. The reason why I made this because I got a lot of comments in my last handmade paper video asking if there is a way to make papers without the blender or without the frame, because some of us don't have it and some of us don't have the permission to use the blender. So here I am with a new video where you can make papers like these without the help of blender. So let's quickly start the video. Okay guys, so first of all we are gonna need some waste papers. I am using notebook like last time, and a lot of you asked me if you can use newspaper or magazine paper. Yes, you can use any kind of paper that is discarded, except used tissue paper. I think that's gross, but you can use any paper. Something very important, we are going to make handmade paper out of waste papers. We are recycling the paper, we are not creating paper from the scratch. Just want to clarify to all of you that I am not cutting trees to show you how to make paper from the scratch. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm going to cut these papers into really small pieces. You can choose to tear it with your hands or as well. It's your choice if you want to cut it or if you want to tear it. Let's do that. Alright guys, so I am done cutting the papers. Now what I'm gonna need is a bottle. I'm using a plastic bottle. This is a cold drink bottle. You can use mineral water bottle as well, or you can use a plastic jar that we get when we buy groceries. And we are gonna pour some hot water, not too hot, otherwise the bottle will start melting. A little warm water, and then we are gonna put these paper inside it. Just fill half of the bottle, and now you're gonna put these paper inside it. See, if you use a bottle that has bigger opening, it will be easier for you to fill the bottle with these papers. But since I have only this bottle, so I'm going to make a little extra effort. Okay, don't fill in a lot of paper in it, because you also need some water to blend with the paper. I know you must be thinking, what am I doing? But this is what is going to replace the blender. So what you need to do is, you need to shake the bottle. So you need to keep shaking until you get the nice smooth paste. I think I'm gonna leave it for 2 or 3 minutes and then I'm gonna shake it again. I'll allow some time for paper to soak in water and then I'll shake this again. So let's come back 2-3 minutes later. Okay guys, so it's been 2-3 minutes. I have added more water in it because I felt that the water and paper ratio was equal. So I think you should have a little extra water for allowing the paper to break and blend in the water. So let's shake this. Okay guys, so I shaked it for good 2-3 minutes, and you can see there is some sort of paste that has been created. It's not as smooth as you get from blender, but I think it's decent enough. And if you keep on shaking it for another 4-5 minutes, I think you'll be able to achieve that. But I am done. I'll show you how to make paper with this paste now. Okay, so this is the paste that we have. I don't like the color of this. I want to add some color. I'm gonna use my photo colors. As you can see, this is transparent photo color. This is what exactly I used in my last video also. And I'm gonna use few drops of this. Like 4 drops of this. Okay, it has nice violet color. I think I'm going to add some pink also because I want the lilac shade, so I'm going to add some pink. I'm adding 2 drops of crimson in it. Quick tip, if you don't have these colors, it's all right. You can use watercolor, you can use food color, you can even use poster or wash color. And I did not suggest using acrylic in my last video. Reason being, acrylics are not eco-friendly. They're very harmful for the environment. So that's why I was suggesting to avoid that. But if you don't have any colors, I mean, you can add acrylic also. Since we are not using any frame or decal or screen or sieve or anything to make the paper, I am using this box lid. It's made of aluminium. You can use a tray that you find in the kitchen where you serve tea or snacks. You can use that. I don't have that tray, so I'm just using this box lid. Make sure this is not made of carton or anything that melts with water. I'm going to spread a fabric on top of this, which will filter out the paper fiber and leave the water at the bottom. And I'm going to use some dry leaves and petals. These are the dry flowers I have. There are some petals of roses, bougainvilleas, and some dry leaves. You can either mix it in the paste or you can sprinkle it later. So I'm just going to mix it right now. So now that your paste is ready, just pour it onto the fabric that is over the tray and then lightly spread this. What I like to do is I'll just use my hands. Okay, please expect this paper to be slightly thicker than the ones that you made with blender. You know, this paste is not as smooth as what you get with blender, so this will have its own different unique texture. Looks like I'm baking something. I love the color. I hope it looks pretty when it's dry. Take another fabric and put it on top of that. Okay. What you're gonna do next is take some dry fabric. I'm using fabric, but you can use sponge, and try to soak up the extra water. Don't press too hard. You can even use a towel for this. Just press it gently. Don't press hard, otherwise it will ruin the paper. It's not as easy to make the paper without a blender and without a sieve. It was truly a challenge. So now it's done. You can either leave it like that to dry and then remove the fabric and see how the paper looks like. But if you want to reuse the tray and reuse the fabric, then we have to take the challenge. We have to flip it onto another surface and see how it looks like. Let's pull this aside. Let's put some fabric. First of all, I'm going to take this off from the tray. I'm going to use it like that. Okay, that's off the paper. I'm going to take off. So this is how it looks like. But what I feel is I'm going to use a rolling pin to make it even flatter. This also needs to be used very gently. Don't press so hard, otherwise again this paper might break. This is my first time, so I am taking my chances. I did not think that I was gonna use this rolling pin, but I am trying because I feel this is still uneven. Now I'm going to lift it off and put it like that. Ta-da! Yay! Looks good. Now, this is the extremely challenging step. lift it up and then put it like that. Yes, your job is done. Now, what? Slowly. Okay. Slowly lift the fabric off. Oh God. See, this is a problem without blender, because it was not even. Okay, I am going to wait for this to dry and see how it looks like. I still feel that this paper might not have as much strength as the other papers have had. So I made two more papers with the same method. As you can see, one in pink and one in aqua blue. I'll wait for it to dry and then I'll show you how it looks like. I hope it doesn't fade much. Make sure that you don't put them in direct sunlight or outdoor, in fact, because they tend to fade the color and they curl a lot. So don't put them in sunlight. Just leave them wherever you are, like in the room temperature inside, and just wait for it to dry. I don't think it's gonna take for 4 or 5 hours. I'll show you once it's dry. Okay guys, so the paper is fully dry, as you can see, and the colors are pretty much the same. They have not faded much. They look different from the back side. They look very light from the back side. I don't know why, but I also like this shade, very pastel and soft. So this was my experience. I kind of like this one the most of all three. I think I'm gonna use it for my journal, or I'm gonna use it as a card or something. I'll try to explore the possibilities to use this paper. Definitely, I feel it's difficult to write on this paper, because of which I feel that I'll still go with the method of using a blender. Since we should always look for all the possibilities, I think this has turned out very well. It looks aesthetic to me. I kind of like how the papers have turned out. I hope you liked it as well, and if you try it, please do not forget to share it with me on my Instagram. I would love to see your versions. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.